Hey guys, we're gonna head down to the track. Gonna give you a, do some, I don't know, moderate speed laps, but not too fast. So I'm just gonna kind of talk about lines and talk about special stuff on the track as we go along, do a couple laps for you. This is a little staging tent. Basically, when you're waiting for the session, you'll come out here and wait. These guys, they're, gotta warm up. Can't warm up without wheelies. I got cold tires, and my students are probably gonna smoke me right now. Into this chicane here. And usually we have stickers on the track. I forgot to mark them. So I'll come back and mark them a little bit later on. Here's one correct sticker. This is the turn in on Big Monza. It's an early apex. Drift out medium. Hold it out a while. Bring it back in nice and tight. Hit the sticker. Flick it over. Yes. So I'll focus on lines first. Here we want to hit the sticker on the outside. Bring it in. That cone marks the apex. This next line is almost exactly the same. Kind of a U to a V. The late turn in. The late apex. Hit this sticker to line us up for the next two turns. Gotta make sure the bike's still working. All right. Bring it out to the left of this crack. Bring it in, late apex. Almost every line out here is a U to a V with a late apex. And the only exception is this turn that's coming up right here. This is called Big Monza. And this is a double apex. So we're going to go into the early apex right here. Early apex. Drift out wide a little bit. Bring it back in. Hit this X right here. Flick it over. Off we go. That's the only line that's significantly different. All the other lines are relatively standardized. Bring it down one here. Apex again. Off we go. The dirt isn't open right now, but I'll take you one time through the dirt just to show you that. Wide turn in, reducing radius, hit the X. Flick it over, fast transition again. Looking sure to make sure nobody's behind me. Now you want to downshift twice for the dirt. Come right around the middle of the berm. Biggest error is that people go below the berm and stand up here through the dirt, rear brake, clutch in, halfway through, start giving a little bit of gas, shift up into third, stand up, and just let it sail off nice and smooth. I'm gonna stop here, let traffic go by so we're not stuffing anybody. But I just wanted to show you the dirt section real quick. Now let's go over what gear we should be in. Fifth gear here, I'm gonna downshift twice, all at once. So I'm taking this in third gear, applying throttle, off the throttle a little bit, flicking it over, or right here, getting on the gas. Fourth, fifth, same thing, gotta downshift twice. I'm sliding in a little bit, but no noise, tires are still cold. Third gear, fourth, fifth, downshift three times into second gear, upshift into third. Now, here's the thing, you want to upshift into fourth right there. It's too early, but it makes it so you don't have to shift twice. Keep it in fourth gear, light trail braking, mostly engine braking through that turn. Out here. Out of laziness, I lifted it fourth. I should have gone down to third. Fifth gear. Downshift twice. Early turn in. Drift out wide. with the X, flick it over. Third gear, fourth gear, fifth gear. Down two, into third. Hit the X, late apex. Now, in order to win practice, this is where you want to do wheelie. Bring it down so we don't crash into anybody. Now let's talk about the track a little bit. It's a bank turn right here. Pretty flat through here. Now this turn, everybody, here's the secret. You want to make it into a straightaway. So you turn it tighter than you think you should, so that you're headed straight for the chicane. Slight push to the right, slight push to the left, late apex, on the front. I want to talk about this one up here. This is big Monza. And a lot of times people want to run wide. I'll show you, they run wide up here. Now here's the deal, it's not that it's a bad line. The asphalt up here sucks, it's kind of choppy. So I usually don't like to run it too high on that one. Again, just tight, medium, tight. Now what I'll do is I'll see if I can free up some, a little space here to do a little bit of a faster lap. Cheat here. That's an easy way to make a pass. Still full tires, so I'm not going to go to town yet. I just did knee down just for the hell of it. Down into third. Catch Crino when he's leading students. What up, Crino? All right, let's talk about brake markers. I use the skid marks on the track. Cars with cones, but cones can move. Look at these skid marks right here. And I brake too early. I'm a sissy on the brakes. I am first to admit that. Now, same thing. We're gonna look for the skid marks right after this entry right here. There's the brake. Sorry, I didn't do a very good job announcing it. I'll announce it when I'm on the brakes next time. And brake. Yeah. Pretty good layout of the track. slightly, not much. Flick it over. Now, one of the biggest mistakes the new riders have is getting on the throttle too soft. Especially on a DRZ. Oh, I meant to do that line the way a racer would do it. Oh, no, for next time. And now I'll try to show you where I get on the throttle. And throttle. Slight taper. And full throttle. Again, not gonna stop anybody. Engine braking. Throttle. It's a secret straightaway right there. Flick it out. Now throttle and full throttle. Gotta get the kids a shotgun. Yes, we're talking about throttle. Is when do you get on the throttle? The scientific answer is when you're done leading the motorcycle. But if you're like me, you don't really know exactly the spot when you're done leaning the motorcycle. Somebody's coming up the inside. Oh, there we go. So, the easier answer is to get on the throttle as soon as you can. Now, how do you know when you can? Heavy feeling, that's when you get on the throttle. If you get on the throttle too hard, now, I mean, really, I don't really shift through those anymore. I looped it one, shifted through, now I'm assisting it, don't do it. Again, I'm in third gear here. Flicking it over, and throttle. Backing it in, but not that impressively. Starting to get tired. Now, another thing I like to talk about, my hands are starting to cramp up. And your hands cramping, that's you not breathing. So, take the school, you hear me, I'm riding one-handed right now. You'll hear me preaching this a lot. Is take, remember to take deep breaths on the motorcycle. Oh, here we go, about to win practice, ready? Woo! And that's a practice win right there. In front of us is our buddy Nathan. He did the school like 8 years ago. So he's just now getting back here and riding with us, which is super rad. Anyway, I hope that was helpful.